Hello and welcome, everyone. To further upgrade my new studio setup, I've ordered my first mechanical keyboard, but it was only $40 and includes a mouse, so I'm trying my best to keep my expectations grounded. However, the Havit HV-KB389L has received thousands of rave reviews online, so maybe there's some potential in this piece of kit we're unboxing and setting up today. As you can see, Havit has wasted no unnecessary effort in sprucing up the packaging. I should mention that this keyboard features blue switches, the loudest of all the mechanical types out there, so you might want to consider a different option if you don't want to piss off your friends or family. Havit is kind enough to include a plastic palm rest that clips on the back of the keyboard. The keyboard itself features an aluminum body that feels sturdy with no flex to it without applying some immense force. Ah, yes. It's been years since I've pressed down on such satisfying keys. They feel great, and not as cheap as some Corsair keyboards I've played around with. Looking at the backside, we can see the model number, as well as two flip-out legs to angle out the keyboard if you should feel the need to do so. Here we have the mouse, a point of contention shared amongst multiple reviewers. It does have a nice texture to it considering its plastic body, but it's not particularly ergonomic and quite large. Considering my hands are rather gargantuan, I actually think it's nice, but time will tell if I'll need to invest in a different one. Time to get this plugged in and see them in action. The multiple RGB lights in the mouse are actually quite impressive, and make for some interesting patterns that breathe and rotate. There's a singular DPI button that cycles through the various sensitivities, which may be a deal breaker for serious first-person shooter fans out there. But it's time to focus on the main attraction, the keyboard itself. These keys have great travel and don't feel like they'll cause fatigue. Typing on it feels great, and I can't wait to perform some extensive stress testing on it. Pressing the function key and F9 will allow you to cycle through its surprisingly extensive RGB patterns. Holding function and pressing the up and down arrow keys allow you to experience each mode with a specific color. I can assure you that these effects are more spectacular in person. My camera seems to show the lights bleeding, but it's actually very clean and a pleasant visual experience that complements the feel of typing on it. Some of you may be pleased to know that it's possible to leave the keys on a solid color without any effects if you so wish. While there's unfortunately no software customization available, there's really something for everyone here, and you can easily kill a half hour trying them all out until you find one that suits you best. You have access to 5 user-defined lighting modes by pressing function and number keys 1 through 5. Once you have a particular profile selected, simply press function and the escape key, and you're able to tap on a key once to turn the light on, and again to turn it off. Doing this repeatedly will cycle through each color, so you power users out there can highlight whatever keys you want most. If you have interest in this keyboard, but want to reduce the bottom out or dampen the noise a bit, I highly recommend a key pulling tool and some O-rings, as they do a pretty decent job of softening the presses and quieting the clack a bit. We're going to pop a clear O-ring on one of these keys so you can hear the kind of difference you can expect. All in all, I have to say, I'm extremely impressed with Havit's budget mechanical keyboard. It really has exceeded my expectations, and its quality is solid and belies its price point. If you're considering a purchase of the HV-KB389L, check the links in the description and consider leaving a comment, a like, or even a subscribe if this video has helped you. Thank you oh so much for tuning in, and I'll see you guys next time.